So every now and then I will get a parent calling me after I have pre-approved a loan for their kids or their stepkids or whatever, and they'll say, what are you doing getting my kids into an FHA loan? Well, there's a lot of misunderstanding and some myths about that, and there's a lot of times where an FHA loan is a great option and sometimes the only option. That's what we're going to be discussing today in thecreditjungle.com. My name is George Anderson, and thanks for joining me. So invariably, there are some people that just think that you are borrowing money from the government when you're getting a government loan. And that is not the case at all. It's not even close to it. FHA and VA are not lenders. They are insurance companies. VA guarantees loans. FHA insures loans. They are just merely an insurance vehicle for the lender, who would be the same type of lender if you were getting a conventional loan. So Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, Ginnie Mae, some of these alphabet soup acronyms. Okay, it's all the same source of money. And if you have less than 20% down, you're going to have either private mortgage insurance or you're going to have government mortgage insurance. And it just depends on what those guidelines are and what the person is trying to accomplish and where, what box do they fit in. So the big negative, excuse me, on the government loans, with as far as FHA is concerned, is the mortgage insurance. No matter how much money you put down, 20%, 50%, you're going to be required to have mortgage insurance on an FHA loan, and you are going to pay that monthly mortgage insurance as a part of your payment for the life of the loan. There is no option to be able to tell FHA that, look, I've got all this great equity in my home, can you please terminate my mortgage insurance? That option isn't available there. So that's the negative that's typically associated with an FHA loan. But on the positive side about it, FHA offers a lot of flexibility. In fact, in 2019, the market share of FHA loans was the highest it's been in 8 years. Well, there's a reason for that. The reason is that FHA has a much more flexible underwriting stance for certain credit situations, certain income situations, and they're just flat out sometimes where, based on a person's circumstances, that might be their only option. Where is FHA different? Well, first of all things being equal, a person who can qualify and maybe is maxed out at $300,000 for a conventional loan will be able to get $340,000 or $350,000 on an FHA loan. Well, yeah, they're going further into debt and they're gonna have a higher mortgage payment. But there's a lot of times where somebody says, well, it's okay because I've got a roommate that's not going to be on the loan, but I got somebody that's going to be helping pay the house payment on there. Well, we might not be able to count that as income towards the loan, but it's something that it's real money coming in. So they know they can afford the payment. There might be overtime, there's bonuses, maybe you got a part-time job that hasn't been on the business long enough or owning a business long enough. There's a lot of factors where people know that they can afford a house payment, where the bank might say that you can't. FHA will give you a little bit more room to stretch and to get into something more expensive as long as you're comfortable with the terms of that. The other thing is that on an FHA loan, the mortgage insurance, the percentage, the premium, the way that it's calculated, is not a function of your credit score. So that is completely different from a conventional loan. Your mortgage insurance premium on a conventional loan is directly related to your credit score, your debt ratios, and in some instances, it might even be the zip code of the property where it's located. So there are some other factors there. FHA doesn't have any of those at all. So if you qualify for an FHA loan, whether your credit score is 800 or 600, your mortgage insurance premium is the same. So that added flexibility in there really gives some options to people that are just worth discussing. And that's what we do when we come into the credit jungle. We're just gonna untangle and unpack all of these different loan options and let you look at your situation. And you might say, well, wait a minute, you know, my payment is only a few dollars a month higher on an FHA loan, but I can get into that one with 3.5% down, whereas on a conventional loan, I might have to put down 5%. Well, that little bit of difference on the payment, you know, 1.5% on a $300,000 home, you know, that's $4,500. I mean, if you don't have the extra money, well, then FHA is a great option for you. But my job is to be able to get your information, figure out what your objectives are, what your goals are, how long you're going to be in the home, and then give you your loan options and explain the positives and the negatives associated with each type of loan program and ultimately help you make the right decision.